Hi, I'm Amy from the Alt Store. Are you interested in a DIY off-grid solar system? That's great news. The Alt Store has sold solar systems to every continent on the planet, and we're still making renewable doubles since we started in 1999. Here are the 6 steps you need to take to get started. Number 1. Figure out how much power you need. This is the most important step, and yet many people try to skip over it. Don't! Planning a solar system without knowing how much power you need is like planning a car trip and not knowing how far you're going and in what vehicle. Okay, now go buy gas for the trip. How much? Well, that depends on your distance and gas mileage. Same with solar. You can't just say, I'm going to buy a couple of solar panels and a battery and hope it'll be enough for my needs. Go to our loads list calculator and enter what you'll be powering with your solar power system. You've got to remember absolutely everything that will be powered by your system. Seemingly little changes can make a big difference. For more details on making a loads list, watch our video Off-Grid Solar Power System Design, Step 1, here. Number 2. Calculate the number of batteries you need. Now that you know how much power you need to figure out how many batteries you need to store it. Do you need only enough storage for a day or two? Do you have another power source like a generator or turbine that will kick in if the sun doesn't shine? Or do you need to have enough batteries to store 3 or 4 days or more worth of power? Will you be storing the batteries in a warm room or will they be in a cold location? Batteries are rated for storage at around 80 degrees Fahrenheit. The colder the room, the bigger the battery bank you need to compensate, by over 50% more if it's below freezing. Each of the answers to these questions affects the size and the cost of your battery bank. What voltage battery bank do you need? 12 volt, 24 volt, or 48 volts? Generally, the larger the system, the higher voltage battery bank you used to keep the number of parallel strings to a minimum and reduce the amount of current between the battery bank and the inverter. If you're just having a small system and want to be able to charge your cell phone and power 12-volt DC appliances in your RV, then a basic 12-volt battery bank makes sense. But if you need to power much over, say, 2,000 watts at a time, you'll want to consider 24-volt and 48-volt systems. Besides reducing how many parallel strings of batteries you'll have to have, it'll allow you to use thinner and less expensive copper cabling between the batteries and the inverter. Go to our off-grid calculator to calculate what size battery bank you need based on these answers. If you want to learn more about sizing the battery bank yourself, watch our video Off-Grid Solar Power System Design Step 2 right here. We've got a big selection of battery types and sizes here. Number 3. Calculate the number of solar panels needed for your location and time of year. Now you can figure out how much solar power you need. The second half of our off-grid calculator can help you figure out how many solar panels you'll need for your solar system. After knowing how much energy you need to make per day from the load calculator, you'll need to tell it how much sunshine you'll have to harvest from. This available energy from the sun for a location is referred to as sun hours. The number of sun hours is basically how many hours the sun is shining on your panels at an angle throughout the day that equals sunlight as if it were shining directly on your solar panels when they get the most power, like at noon. As you know, the sun isn't as bright at 8 a.m. as it is at noon, so an hour of morning sun may be counted as a half a sun hour, where the hour from noon to 1 p.m. would be a full sun hour. And unless you live near the equator, you do not have the same number of hours of sunlight in the winter as you do in the summer. You want to take the worst case scenario for your area, the season where you've got the least amount of sunshine that you'll be using the system. That way you do not end up short on solar energy part of the year. If it's a summer camp, you don't need to plan for winter. But if it's a year-round home or a hunting cabin, you need to tell it the number of sun hours that correspond to the winter. Luckily, It's easy to figure out the sun hours for anywhere in the world with our calculator or using sun hour maps. If you're planning on year-round in the USA, enter the city nearest you from the drop-down menu. If you're elsewhere in the world, we have some maps that you can use for reference here and enter the sun hours. The calculator will tell you how many watts of solar panels you need for your system. For more details on sizing your solar array, watch our video, Off-Grid Solar Power System Design Step 3, here. We've got a large selection of solar panels and of different voltages and wattages here. Number 4, select a solar charge controller. All right, so we have the batteries and we have the solar. Now we need a way to manage putting the power from the solar into the batteries. An extremely rough calculation to figure out what size charge controller you need is to take the watts from the solar, in our example here it's 500 watts, and divide it by the battery bank voltage, in this case 24 volts. That gives us 21 amps. Add another 25% for a safety factor, and you're going to need a charge controller that can handle at least 26 amps. So we'll probably round up to a 30 amp charge controller. Now, there's also a bit more to consider when selecting a charge controller. Charge controllers are available with two major types of technologies, PWM and MPPT. We've done a video explaining the difference between the two. You can see that here. But in short, if the voltage of the solar panel array matches the voltage of the battery bank, you can use a PWM charge controller. So if you have a 12-volt panel and a 12-volt battery bank, you can use PWM. If your solar panel voltage is different than the battery bank and can't be wired in series to make it match, you need to use an MPPT charge controller. So if you have a 20-volt solar panel and you have a 12-volt battery bank, you need to use MPPT. To see more on how to size the different options, go watch our off-grid solar power system design step 4. We carry both PWM and MPPT charge controllers here. Number 5, select an inverter. Now that we have efficiently charged batteries, we need to make the power usable. If you're only running DC loads straight off your battery bank, you can skip this step. But if you're powering any AC loads, you need to convert the DC current, the direct current, from the batteries into the AC alternating current for your appliances. It's very important to know what type of AC power you need. If you're in North America, the standard is 120-240 split phase 60 Hz. In Europe and much of Africa and some countries in South America, it's 230 volts single phase 50 Hz. In some islands, it's an interesting mixture of both. Some inverters are configurable between voltages and or frequencies. Many are fixed. So check the specs carefully of the inverter you're interested in to make sure it matches your needs. If you do have the North American standard, you must figure out if you have any appliances that use 240 volts, or if they're all just 120 volts. Some inverters are able to put out 240 volts, and then you wire the output to use either 120 or 240 volts. Other inverters are stackable, each one outputting 120 volts, but when wired together, or stacked, they can create 240 volts. And others are only capable of outputting 120 volts and can't be stacked. Again, read the specs to determine which inverter is right for you. You also need to know how many watts total your inverter will need to power. Luckily, way back in step 1, you created a loads list that figured out both the constant watts and the surge requirements of your loads. Please note that an inverter is designed for a specific voltage battery bank, like 12, 24, or 48 volts. They're usually not field selectable, so you need to know what voltage battery bank you're going to have before you settle on the inverter. Keep this in mind if you think you may be growing your system in the future. If you plan on having a higher voltage battery bank later, be aware that the lower voltage inverter won't work in the new, bigger system. So either plan ahead and go with a higher voltage to begin with, or plan on changing out your inverter in the future. For more details on selecting inverters, see our video, Off-Grid Solar Power System Design Step 5. We carry inverters for North America and rest of world with a variety of voltages and wattages here. Number 6, balance of system. Okay, yes, I'm kind of cheating by lumping everything else into one step for balance of system. But there are a lot of other little components needed, like the fuses and breakers for overcurrent protection. What breaker box will you use? How are you going to mount the solar panels? What size wire do you need? We've got more videos that can help you out with a lot of these details, like solar power components part 4, and wiring your solar power system. We've also created some off-grid solar kits that have a lot of balance of equipment system already selected. So you can see them here. Since solar really isn't one size fits all, they can be a great starting point to your own custom solar system. Once you've gone through these 6 steps, you'll have a great start to designing your own DIY solar system. Give us a call with any questions or if you want help designing a system. Also, check out more of our videos here for more details. If you found this video to be informative, please like and share the video and subscribe to our channel, AltiStore. Also, go to our website at altistore.com, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.